Krajicnik had gone up to the maps and, slamming them with his fist, had said, "I live here." He's pointing to a farm he has in Ilija. "And I'm never going to give this up." And 6 hours later, they had practically restarted the war.
Milosevic told Holbrook he would settle this himself. He made a startling offer to the Muslims' negotiator.
He said, "You deserve Sarajevo because you fought for it. And those cowards killed you from the hills," meaning the Bosnian Serbs.
Milosevic gave it to him. I was amazed.
It soon became clear the Serb president required something in return.
Sarajevo came and announced that Milosevic insisted on the city of Brčkov.
The town of Brčko was the spot where the Serb Republic could be severed in two. It would give the Muslims a way to stop fresh Serb aggression. President Izetbegovic told the Prime Minister that on this he had to be tough.
Ja sam rekao Silajdžiću da ma koliko da je ovdje narod očekivao da će doći do nekakvog mira, mislim da bi puno teže primio vijest o tome da je plaćena tako visoka cijena kao što je Brčko.
The Prime Minister returned to put Izetbegovic's counter demand for Brčko.
President Milosevic would not agree. He said, "We must solve that thing now. I must have 15 to 20 kilometer corridor."
Milosevic won this one, and Silajdžić still had to find a way to reduce the Muslim-Croat share to 51%. In the small hours of the morning, he had an idea. He offered to return a huge chunk of territory that Muslim Croat forces had taken from the Serbs just before the conference.
And they shook hands and they said, "Okay, we've got an agreement."
So we actually brought in a bottle of wine that the secretary had brought with him, and he said, "Let's celebrate."
Where every previous attempt had failed, the Americans had succeeded. They'd ended the war in Bosnia. But in their excitement, they forgot the Croat delegation.
Državni tajnik Christopher je predložio da će on doći između oko jedan sat nakon konačnih razgovora sa Miloševićem. On nije došao do jedan, mi smo ga čekali do negdje dva sata. Oko 2:30 smo išli spavati.
I just felt that something was very wrong here. And I leaned over to Chris Hill and said,
"Better get Tuđman in here." And I said, "Dick, it's 4:15. How about I'll get Mate Granić?"
Kazao je da bi državni tajnik želio sa mnom razgovarati hitno.
Granić arrived sometime at 4:15 or 4:20 in the morning, dressed impeccably.
I could see him sort of looking to the side because he could see something that looked like a map.
I oni su me nudili šampanjcem. Ja sam tražio vode prije nego što vidim prijedloge njihove konačne mape.
And we produce the map. And Mate Granić, mild-mannered physician, turns into a rhinoceros.
Because the map actually cut into what mainly Croat forces took from Serbs in western Bosnia.
I oni su mi predložili potpuno neprihvatljiv prijedlog.
He jumps up, hits the map with his hand, says, "Impossible, impossible, 0.00% chance my president will accept this."
Ja sam to energično odbio i rekao da to nema 0.0 chance za prihvatiti i da je to absolutely unacceptable za nas.
And he turns on Silajdžić and he just rips him. Says, "You have given away the territory we conquered."
Remember, it was almost 20 days of negotiating. We were all very much exhausted, very little sleep.
In 37 minutes, the peace agreement had collapsed. It was left to President Clinton to try to rescue the conference. He phoned the Croat president and asked him to surrender some of the territory they'd refused to give up the night before.
Ja sam predsjedniku Clintonu rekao, "Dear President, I already did that." Ja, jer sam ja već odlučio da znači da zbog, molim, ovih nekoliko kilometara brdovitog kamena ne dovedemo u pitanje mir.
But, he said, I will do it only if the Bosnians also give up part of the land they claim.
U pola 11 na večer je došao kod mene Kristofer, nije skidao kaput, s nogom je rekao da hoće naš stav definitivan u roku od sata vremena.
I did lose my calm a little bit with him, and some have said I shouted at him. That may be a little overstatement, but I'm quiet enough so when I raise my voice it's noticeable.
Odgovor je glasio, procente smo uskladili, ali kad je riječ o Brčkom, Brčko ne možemo da.
He asked that Brčko, given to the Serbs the night before, be decided by arbitration.
I told him, you know, this was the end of the line and I was not going to try to negotiate something else for him.
The United States has already told the Balkan delegations the talks will end in a few hours without a Bosnia peace agreement.
Milosevic and Tudjman now got together. From the beginning of the crisis in Yugoslavia, they had determined the fate of Bosnia. Milosevic suggested the two of them sign without Izetbegović.
Ja sam ukazao da na to ne mogu pristati.
I predsjednik Tudjman je predložio predsjedniku Miloševiću da prihvati prijedlog predsjednika Izetbegovića o arbitraži.
Milošević je rekao možda nije mi na taj moj prijedlog.
Holbrooke and his team were starting an exhausted post-mortem on the conference when Milosevic burst in.
Milosevic says, okay, my last offer, the most I can ever do for you, I would agree to put the city of Brčko under international arbitration to be decided in a year.
Sigurno da se sve koncesije koje su učinjene ne mogu uporediti sa ostvarenjem rezultata, to je mir.
This time, before celebrating, they checked with all the parties.
Ja sam prihvatio naravno Kristofera i samo me upitao, ostajete li dalje pri arbitraži za Brčko?
We've got to decide right now. And there was a very, very long pause.
Ja sam rekao, ostajem. On je samo rekao, onda je sve u redu.
And I said to Warren Christopher, let's get out of here.
Dick Holbrooke looked like he was in front of a gas chamber and they just pulled him back. I hope he watches this.
I wonder if we could ask the three presidents to stand up and for us to join them standing and express our appreciation for what they've done in Dayton and our hopes for the future.
Today, 6 months later, the Dayton peace is still holding. Just.